What's going on, guys? If you're new to my channel, it's super sick to have you here, and if you're not new, then welcome back. Oh, as summer comes to an end, I kind of like to reflect on things that I did this summer, like things I did with my friends, places I went, events we went to, and along with all that, I also like to reflect on the music I listen to, because as you know, music is a really big part of my life. It keeps me sane most of the time, and I just love music. I love to talk about it. I love to talk to other people about music, figure out what they like to listen to. It's just one of my favorite all-time topics to talk about. So I decided to put together a list of my top five songs that I think defined my summer. And this was a really hard list to make because I listened to a lot of music, so there were a lot of songs that I really vibed with and really impacted me during the summer. But these specific songs are just songs that I have very vivid memories of listening to them, and I think they kind of just defined my summer as a whole. So I thought I would share those songs with you and kind of reflect back on memories that I've had during the summer with these songs. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the video. So the first song that I've written down on my list is Comfort by Nicholas Galitzine. I need comfort, but I hate being comfortable. I wonder why I hate getting what I want. If you don't know, Nicholas Galitzine is the actor that played Prince Henry on Red, White, and Royal Blue. I did a whole video on that movie, so if you haven't, go and check that out. But as I was learning more about Nicholas and like through the movie and stuff, I discovered that he dabbles in music making, and this song is the only song he has out right now, but he himself says he wants to kind of dabble in music making and kind of put out a few more songs and maybe even put out an album. So I listened to the song and I immediately fell in love with it. I had it on repeat for weeks because it is just such a good song. The song, I think, is about his struggle to find love and to hold on to it. Also, if you listen to the song, it's a really nice, I would consider it a pop song. The melody's nice, the lyrics are amazing. I think for a first song, it's really good. He does a lot of covers on, he has done a lot of covers in the past. He still has some up on his TikTok and Instagram, but he's been doing covers for a really, really long time, so he's not new to singing. I think his voice is very beautiful, and I'm excited to see where he goes with music making and the other stuff he puts out, because I'm really interested in what else he's gonna put out. So the second song on my list is Amen by Bring Me the Horizon featuring Lil Uzi Vert and Daryl Palumbo, I think is how you say his last name. So tell all your friends, this is the end of everything. Too late to repent, we can rewrite this song. I remember listening to this song for the first time when they put it out, and I feel like it altered my brain chemistry because I was obsessed with this song when it first came out. I still am, but like I had it on repeat so much. Like this song is so good. Like I remember, like if you've heard the song, it's a metalcore track, so it opens up so big. And I'm just like, I remember listening to it and my jaw was on the floor like the entire time I was listening to it, because I was like, what is this? Like, it's such a good song. If you haven't listened to it, you need to. And it also, what shocked me is it featured Lil Uzi Vert, who is a rapper, as a well-known rapper, as we all know. But I do know that Lil Uzi Vert does like that type of music, like rock and metal. Twins. But I was just so kind of excited to see how Lil Uzi was gonna do on the song, and I really, really like his verse on that song. I kind of wish it was longer. It is kind of short, but this song, I have such vivid memories of listening to this for the first time, and I've had a really big, I mean, I've been in love with Bring Me the Horizon, but I had a really big Bring Me the Horizon hyperfixation this summer, so I was kind of like just listening to their songs a lot. She looks so creepy. Do you see her? I had a really big hyperfixation on them this summer, and this song kind of just really fueled that. I'm also really excited for the album. If you're a Bring Me the Horizon fan, you know that they're about to put out a new album, and it got pushed back, sadly. It was supposed to come out this month, but Ali came out with a statement saying it was being pushed back because of some like difficulties, so that was kind of sad. But I'm really, really excited to hear that album and see what it is gonna sound like as a whole. The third song I have on my list is Always There by Greta Van Fleet. If you know me, you know I am a massive Greta Van Fleet fan. I listened to this song a lot this summer because I just love it. I love Greta Van Fleet anyway, but this song specifically has such a summer vibe to me. It's so, I don't even know. Like, you just have to listen to, like, I just don't know how to explain it. It's like, I think everything that Greta Van Fleet puts out is amazing, and their lyricism is so good. I love it. I love everything about their songs, the lyrics, the instruments, the melodies, the beats. It's just all great. But this song, there's not much to say. I mean, you could listen to the song and it speaks for itself. If you haven't listened to Greta Van Fleet in general, allow me to introduce you and change your life, because that's what it did for me when I discovered them. Greta Van Fleet has literally changed my life so much. But it's a really good band, and this song is really good. So yeah, I feel like this song itself has really kind of had a pinpoint in my summer memories. So the fourth song on my list is Open a Window by Rex Orange County featuring Tyler the Creator.
So can I open a window? Can somebody open the door?
I said before, if you haven't seen my vinyl collection video, go ahead and check that out. But in that video, I said that Rex's latest album, Who Cares, is such a summer album to me. All the songs give summer vibes. They're very upbeat and poppy. So I was kind of listening to that specific album a lot lately. But this specific song screams summer. It's so like vibey, and like, especially with Tyler on it. Tyler the Creator is so talented, so like, I knew as soon as I saw his name on this song, he was gonna kill it. But this song, I did have this song on repeat, probably a lot more than the other songs on the album, but I think these two artists as a duo are really good. And it's a duo I didn't expect to see, like, because Rex Orange County is also on Tyler the Creator's album, Flower Boy. And I love all the songs that Rex is on that album too. So whenever, you know, they make songs together, I expect it to be good, because I think they have a really great sound when they get together. Yeah, this song and this whole album as a whole is just so summer coded to me, and I really, really love this song. So if you haven't heard it, or if you haven't listened to that album, go listen to it, because it is such a summer album and it will change your life. Now the last song I have on this list is probably a song that a lot of people can relate to, because this song did come out this summer, and that's What Was I Made For by Billie Eilish.
When did it end? All the enjoyment, I'm sad again. Don't tell my boyfriend.
So obviously this song was made for the Barbie movie that pretty much everyone saw this summer. I've seen the Barbie movie 3 times. and each time I loved it even more than I did the last time I saw it. The Barbie movie is such a, I think, important film this year, and the message in it is so important for women. And it is important for men too, but obviously men won't get it as much as women do, because it's what we live through every single day. So men are gonna, some men are like, yeah, I totally get that, but they won't, you know, experience it. So Barbie movie is a really, really important movie for womanhood. What Was I Made For by Billie Eilish. This song, I don't even really have the words for how this song has made me feel. I mean, like, if you listen to the song and the lyrics, you already know, like, it's just so relatable. when it comes to women and how. So when you're younger, you live in this state of oblivion and like bliss, like you don't know about like the world problems and like things that your parents stress about and like just things. You don't know about the problems of the world, and you live in this state of looking through rose-colored glasses and like everything's fine and like, you know, you don't have to worry about anything. And as you grow as a woman, you start to realize things that women go through every day. So like sexual assault and getting catcalled by men and not getting paid enough or the same as men and like being seen as an object. It's all very jarring when you do start to learn about it as you grow up. And that feeling of being a young girl and not having to worry about anything and feeling like you're on top of the world it just gets ripped away from you because reality hits you so quickly that you don't have time to like really adjust for it. And it's an unfortunate thing that we can't really avoid. So this song is so important because I think it describes how a lot of, especially young women, feel this day and age. And it definitely described how I feel now, because, you know, I feel like a lot of our generation feels very lost and we're held to such high expectations for the world. And I think we as a generation are trying to change things, and people that are older than us kind of aren't. They just want to keep it the same way, and even more, they want to take us backwards, especially in America right now. It feels like we've gone back so far and we're not really growing as a country. So it's a little upsetting, and you feel helpless sometimes because you don't really know how to help, and like if you can even help. So with all that being said, I don't know if that any of that made sense, but this song is it holds a very special place in my heart for not just this summer, but for, you know, ever. This song will hold a special place in my heart, but specifically this summer, this song has really, really, really been engraved into my mind, and the message behind it is very important, and I love this song, and I can't say enough good things about it. So those were my top 5 songs of the summer. I only chose 5 because I felt like if I did 10, that would be like kind of too much. But yeah, it was very, very hard to make this list because, like I said before, I had a lot of songs that really impacted me and like stuck in my mind this summer, but these were just the ones that I felt had very, very core memories when it came to this summer. So that is all I have for you today. This was kind of I didn't really know how to feel about this video idea, but I decided to do it anyway because I never know if you guys might like it. So if you do like videos like this of me talking about music, feel free to let me know. And if you have any video ideas for me, leave them down in the comments. With that being said, that is all I have for you today. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and leave a comment down below of what songs defined your summer, and if you have any distinct memories with these songs. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.